मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई डॉक्टर जेवीएन डॉक्टर वाई चंद्र कला. गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई जेवीएन डॉक्टर वाई चंद्र कला, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटनरी साइंस. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस फ्रॉम प्लांट इकोलॉजी पार्ट, एयर पोल्यूशन. So let's first discuss about what is atmosphere. Atmosphere is the life blanket of earth. It is therefore essential that we know more about atmosphere and ways in which it is polluted. In an average, a human breathes 22,000 times a day and takes 16 kg of air each day. All the impurities in the inhaled air do not necessarily cause harm, but sometimes some harmful particles are present in the air in small concentration also enough to cause diseases. Air pollution is the contamination of indoor and outdoor environment by any chemical, physical or biological agent that modifies the natural characteristic of the atmosphere. A healthy atmosphere gets contaminated. It may be any chemicals which we use in our surrounding, maybe any physical sources of it or any biological agents can cause it. So we can say that it is one of the greatest environmental evils. So when we see about the sources, how it is air get polluted in the environment, the household combustion devices we use in our house itself, like using chula in artificial chulas in village levels, in even motor vehicles, industrial facilities like outlet of industries, various industries are having the chimney outlet, though they are very high, but still they cause effect or add on to the pollution by releasing harmful chemical into the environment. Forest fires, when forest get fired, so lots of carbon dioxide is released, monoxide is released, includes the particulate particles, carbon monoxide, ozone, chlorofluorocarbons, which is the one of the most factor for depleting the ozone layer, nitrogen dioxide and sulfur dioxide. In this picture we can see that the primary pollutants such as the carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide, nitrogen dioxide, which comes from various sources like automobiles, car, stationery, from different power plants, different volcano eruptions, different kinds of gases comes out, which we can say they are as a primary pollutants. These primary pollutants combine themselves then with air and other substances, water molecules, and they convert into a secondary pollutants causing, like that of nitrate, sulfuric acid. So these secondary pollutants are much more harmful when it comes in the form of acid rains. The main causes, we can see the few main causes like that. Carbon dioxide, this happens because of the deforestation, fossil fuel burning. As the forest is, we are removing a forest or cutting down the trees, and so the carbon dioxide level is now increasing. Sulfur dioxide, which comes from the burning of the fossil fuel, sulfur oxides also, which are very dangerous to the human concentration. Sulfur in the atmosphere is responsible for acid rain, which cause depletion in the monuments, buildings, consequences of air pollutions. Carbon dioxide, when is transmitter, is a good transmitter of sunlight, but it also partially restricts the infrared radiation going back from the earth into the space, which produces the so-called greenhouse effect that prevents a drastic cooling and of the earth during the night time. That when carbon dioxide is increased in the atmosphere, it lead to the global warming. Effect of air pollution on human beings, plants and animals. In if you see in a global way, in a global scenario, when we come talk about the air pollution, it affects the human beings. At the same time, it affects plants and animals also. Greenhouse effects, ozone depletion, heat in the islands, melting of ices, submerging of the islands, dust storms, automobile pollutions and photochemical smokes. So engines, the fuels which is coming out of the fumes or the smoke which is coming out of the engines burning, which affects the plant, human and animals also. It affects depending upon many things like nature of the pollutants, what type of pollutant it is, the concentration of the pollutant which affects the environment, at what concentration it is actually polluting the environment, the duration of exposure time, how much time the the plant or a human being is getting exposure to that particular pollutant, the state of healthy of the receptor, the state at what which condition the human being is, the person age and the age group also. So it varies from person to person, it varies with environment and climatic conditions. As we can see, we get when we get exposure to the air pollution, we get headache, various kind of respiratory infections when it coming in contact with different biological contamination, in the sense of pollution, in the sense of bacteria, chemicals, the fumes or the chemicals which are coming out of the soil, like that of the after spraying pesticide in the field, the chemical chemicals which is in the form of vapors or which comes in a contact with human beings, different kinds of volatile substances, that organic compounds, inorganic compounds, leading to cancer, nausea, different kind of skin irritations in the human, and definitely it affects the plants also in the same way, by reducing their yield, productions and ultimately the cause of death also. Affects when it comes reducing the lungs functioning in human, it is like reducing the lungs functioning, irritation of eyes, nose, throat, asthma attacks, respiratory systems of coughing and wheezing, increased respiratory diseases such as bronchitis, reduce the energy level, creating different diseases like neurobehavior disorders, cardiovascular problems, cancers and premature death. So how we can avoid the air pollution? When this pollution is creating a lot of disturbance in our natural atmosphere, in a healthy atmosphere, how we can create a healthy atmosphere? So we can reduce the use of fossil fuels or harmful gases and replacing them with LPG gases for our automobiles, like cooking gases, and as far as possible we can reduce the use of harmful gases in our environment, raising awareness about the air pollution so that each one can maintain the level of pollution to a limitation point that we can create. No, we have to make limitations that we should not create pollution in the air. Plantation of more trees as far as possible, each one, if we plant one more trees in our environment, we can conserve or we can maintain the atmospheric condition in a good and healthy way. Bursting crackers is a very common thing which create air pollution, so we can avoid the bursting of crackers during festivals, so a lot of pollution can be reduced. Use less amount of fuels or taking public vehicles for the transportation, avoiding one-to-one vehicle, it itself make a lot of air reduction in our air pollution. Avoiding use of different electric stoves which really eliminates lot of gases, so instead of that we can switch on to biogases so that we can keep our air clean.